Hey, what's going on here? Sun is even shining, I can't believe it. After only half a year of winter.
Ta-da! What's that? Skyline of Munich.
Skyline?
Ta-da!
You call that a skyline? That's the most embarrassing skyline I have seen in my whole life.
Since we have our new Model 3, we haven't been in the city, right? An electric car is actually perfect for the city, right?
Yeah. So today we're gonna do a test of the Model 3 performance, an efficiency test, because we got the car now since a few weeks and I would really like to know how efficient the car is in city driving.
That's true.
How much does it consume? Like how many watt hours per kilometer, you know? And then we can calculate the range of how long the Model 3 performance can drive in city and stop and go traffic. Let's go.
Let's go.
Starting now, and now we even have not shaky footage. Isn't that amazing? Extra for you, dear viewers. You know, if that isn't worth a subscription, then I don't know what is.
Wow.
Ooh, look at this. Yeah, we have one camera here filming us from the front and one from the back. That's freaking crazy. I can't believe it. And of course, she's again driving so that I can just have a good time. And she can practice driving, right?
That's true.
Because you have to practice a lot still.
That's true.
She's a beginner, you know? She's a driving beginner.
Aww.
That's so cute. Look at her, how cute she is when she drives. And we already have now the best traffic situation possible. So. We'll now start the efficiency test in city driving. Look, that's nice stop and go traffic we have right here. It's like rush hour in Munich. Nothing goes anymore. So we like constantly have to stop and start and stop and go and so on. Normally I had to hold the camera and it was shaky everywhere. And now we can just like with our superior equipment that we bought for a lot of money, it was expensive. We spent so much money so that you guys have good footage and now we're poor and we cannot even afford anything to eat anymore. Thanks a lot, you know, thanks a lot. So our consumption is around 191 watt hours per kilometer since we started this trip.
Not so bad.
191 watt hours per kilometer until now. It's 7.7 kilometers the whole trip distance until now. So this would translate to a maximum range of not quite 400 kilometers, not quite 400, 380, 390, 380, 390, but it's still too early. We still need a bit more kilometers to have a more like a realistic average number. We'll now be very near to the technical TUM, the Technical University of Munich.
I think it has the highest ranking among all the universities in Germany, right?
It has a quite high ranking in Germany, but internationally, of course,
it's
quite an embarrassing ranking. It's, I think, on place 50. Internationally, on place 50. That's kind of embarrassing. But they still pretend like, oh, it's a super nice international elite, top elite university, you know?
Yeah.
So we've driven now 11 kilometers and our energy consumption is 192 watt hours per kilometer in the most insane traffic conditions that you can imagine, which is still quite good. It's still quite nice. Now our consumption for the last 22.2 kilometers since we started went down to 179 watt hours per kilometer. So as soon as you have some stretches where you drive for longer periods of time with a constant speed, then your energy consumption immediately goes down. Quite funny. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And now the very interesting stuff. How was our consumption? We see that on a total trip of almost 30 kilometers, 29.5 kilometers, we have an average consumption now of 171 watt hours per kilometer. Considering that most of the time we were in insane stop and go traffic and only in the last 10-15 minutes we were able to drive like with a constant speed, considering these things, I would say that the energy consumption is absolutely efficient. Absolutely amazing. 171 hour watt hours per kilometer means, do you have a calculator here?
Yeah.
The battery that we can use is 72 kilowatt hours. That's 3 kilowatt hours reserved for like a buffer. So now divided by 17.1 gives 421 kilometers of range. That's amazing. That's in like insane stop and go traffic under the worst possible circumstances you can imagine. So what's happening now? I driving now suddenly or what?
Yes.
Why?
Because we want to see if your driving style is better than mine.
I wouldn't say better, but I will drive very efficiently now, and we want to test how the energy consumption in city driving, like with stop and go traffic, is when you try to drive as efficiently as possible. She's still a driving beginner, so for her it's like a bit difficult to drive efficiently because she's like kind of nervous. She has not the driving experience, and for me it's like relaxing. When I drive, I'm actually relaxing, you know? It's relaxation for me, so I can drive and chill out at the same time. So we'll try the city traffic test that we did yesterday, but I will try to drive as smoothly and as efficiently as possible. There's always a lot of commotion, always a lot of stuff going on, but somehow in this car it still feels super relaxing because this car is so nice to drive. It's like the driving feeling of this car, you cannot describe it. It's like it's so firm on the road. It feels like you drive on like a railroad. It feels like you drive on rails. It's like so firm and on the road and like so smooth at the same time. Amazing, the driving feeling of this car. It's really amazing.
What's going on? Huh?
We are waiting for the traffic light. Do something.
We are waiting for the traffic light to finally turn green. It would be really nice, yeah.
Driving quite efficient.
We're at 161 watt hours per kilometer. What kind of chart is this here? Now that is highly interesting.
So I didn't think that Tesla had an internet function for this kind of purpose.
That's the best thing in this car. You can watch the Bitcoin chart all the time in high resolution in the browser. Wonderful, Tesla. Perfect. I freaking love it. Okay, it might be a bit distracting. I admit it might be a bit distracting. So, wow. Last 17.9 kilometers, 154 watt hours per kilometer. And look, we're still doing stop and go. Okay, there was now a stretch where we could drive for a more like a few kilometers with a regular speed, with a constant speed,
that's
you know.
True.
But still, overall, we did stop and go traffic. And this shows that the driving style, how careful you are with the brakes and like with a acceleration pedal, that really makes a difference. It really makes a difference.
If you haven't known, my name is Ji Xuan. Actually, my name is Ji Xuan. But he told me that nobody would remember this name. So he has invented a new Americanized name for me. So please teach me again.
Ji Xuan.
Ji Xuan. Ji Xuan. Ji Xuan. And if you like, enjoyed our video, we would be very glad if you give us a like. And maybe even consider to subscribe. I think every day we will come up with some new, weird, strange ideas to test our Model 3 performance in Munich.
Absolutely, we still have many ideas.
It's really an amazing car, right?
It's really the best car I've ever had in my life and the best car I've ever driven in my life. Now it says 150, look at this. 150 watt hours per kilometer. That's an amazing efficiency in city traffic. I mean, this is in stop and go city traffic.
So I hope you like our video and you see, unfortunately, I'm not driving very efficiently. I was not driving very efficiently.
The difference is not so high. Don't be sad, you're still a driving beginner.
I'm the best driver in the world.
Joking aside, you see that driving style really does make a difference. How gentle you are on the pedals, the acceleration and brake pedal, you can really influence your efficiency.
And we would be glad if you continue watching, if you would check out our other videos and maybe give us a like.
Mm-hmm.
So see you next time.
Ciao.